عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته and Ramadan Mubarak to you all. Today, inshallah, we are going to introduce to you the Palestinian Qidra. And today, Dr. Ala Khalil is cooking the Qidra for us. Assalamu alaikum, Ala.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
How are you?
Alhamdulillah, fine. Thank you, Abir.
Ramadan Mubarak to you and your family.
To you too, inshallah, Abir.
Inshallah. So today, you are going to cook for us the
Al-Qidra.
The Palestinian?
It's a very famous dish. We usually find it in almost every social event here in Palestine.
Yes, okay? Indeed. Yeah, it's very famous in Palestine. That's why we are going to introduce it to you. So, Ala, can you tell us a little bit about the ingredients of this dish?
Okay, the main ingredient is meat and rice. Okay,
meat and rice.
In addition to onions and some spices.
Yeah, can you tell us a little bit about the spices? What are they?
Okay, we have bay leaves.
Bay leaves.
And
cardamom.
Yes.
Yeah, cardamom.
Salt. Qidra spices.
Just let us tell you a little bit about the Qidra spices. It's usually a mix of a number of spices, and here in Palestine we'd like to make it easier for the women. So in the here you can have black pepper, you have pepper, you have also turmeric as well, and other mixture of nice spices.
We also have chili, and oil.
Yeah, this is corn oil, or we have as well sunflower oil.
Yes. Garlic.
Yes.
Tomato, but it's...
It's optional.
Yes, it's optional, and in the traditional Qidra, they don't use it. Okay? But I prefer to use it.
Yes. Okay. And this is chickpeas.
Yes.
Yeah, and usually this is rinsed chickpeas. You have to let it simmer in water for overnight.
And cook after that.
Yes, some people would cook it, and others would, if you leave it overnight, it would be nice.
And we have al-qidra. You have to use it while cooking al-qidra rice.
Yeah, so let me tell you why it is called al-qidra. Actually, the dish is called after the pot we are cooking it in. So this pot is clay pot. It's very famous for the Palestinian people to use it in their cooking. That's why we call it Al-Qidra. But to tell you a little bit about the difference between some parts of Palestine in cooking Al-Qidra, in Gaza we use the clay pot like this one, but in the West Bank they use the copper pot. And the people in Hebron, the city of Hebron or the city of Khalil, are very famous for cooking Al-Qidra, and they are considered the main people who created Al-Qidra, and then Gaza followed them. But we have a little bit of different techniques for using them. Ala, do you think if our friends in Malaysia want to cook Al-Qidra, they can find something similar to this one?
Yes, but with a little bit differences. They can find it in Chinese houseware stores. Okay, the difference mainly is the in the inside of this pot.
Yeah, I think in the inside it is painted with a little bit of porcelain. Yeah,
yeah.
But for this Palestinian one, because it's totally made of a clay, you have to simmer it with water at night so that it won't burn the food in the morning, and you have to put some ghee inside it before putting the ingredients. Yeah. So now, yeah, let's start.
At first, we are going. Actually, as you said, I submerge it in water the whole night. Okay.
Yeah.
Now we are going to use some of the ghee.
Yes.
To put it inside the wall of the pot. Okay.
Yeah. So you are spreading the ghee around the pot from the whole inside.
Yeah. After putting the ghee, we are going to add the meat inside the pot.
Yes. I think this is, you can use veal meat or lamb meat.
Yeah, but usually they use lamb meat.
Lamb meat, I think it's better because it has, you know, the fat. Yeah, we need, this dish is usually fatty, and the fat is what makes the nice flavor for it.
Now we are going to add the water.
Yes. So are you going to cover the whole meat with water?
Yes.
All right.
We are going to add bay leaves now.
Yes. I think this is to give the flavor for the meat and to remove all the bad odors from it.
Yes. And cardamom.
Yeah. We love to add cardamom in almost every dish.
Okay, now we will cover it with aluminium foil.
Mm-hmm.
After that, we are going to put it in the clay oven.
Yeah, we put it in the clay oven so that the meat will be cooked. Yeah, this way we keep the steam inside.
Yes, of course. While we will cook the meat, we are going to prepare the ingredients for the rice.
Okay? Uh-huh, tamam, yeah.
Put it in the clay oven.
Yes.
Going to leave it around 1 hour, 2 hours. It depends on the type of the meat. Okay.
Yeah, around 1 hour, 2 hour until the meat is nice and easy to eat. Yeah. Ala, what's next now?
Inshallah, we are going to prepare the mix for the rice.
Yes. Okay. Can I help you? What do you need?
The oil.
Yeah. So we put the oil into the pot. Careful of the fire. All right, what else? Put the onion, I think. As you can see, we need to add some amount of onion, around 5 or 6 onions.
Now we are going to add the garlic.
Mm-hmm.
We don't peel it.
Yeah, we keep it without peeling the. As we said earlier, tomato is optional. In some parts of Palestine, they don't add tomato.
Give me the spices, please, Amir.
Yes.
Going to look at the meat in the clay oven, okay? And after that, we are going to add this mix on the meat with the rice and then put it again in the clay oven to be cooked.
Yeah, so this means we first cooked the meat inside the clay oven, and then this mixture we add it with the rice again to the clay pot when the meat is finally cooked. The rice with the spices that were cooked with the onion, because we want every piece of rice to be coated with the spices and the mixture. Look at the color, how beautiful it is. The yellow color and the all of the rinsed spices, the beautiful flavor that we will have, and add to that the meat that we cooked after this. Look at the color. smell of the cooked meat is amazing. And now I think we will add the rice.
Yes,
yes, we add it to the meat with its water and the broth and everything.
After putting all the rice, we are going to stir it, okay, now?
Yeah, stir it so that everything will be... Meat. Wow, yeah, it's very well cooked.
Yeah. Hmm.
Now we rinse it very well because we need all the water or the broth to be covered evenly with the rice.
Going to cover it again.
We seal it with the aluminium foil so that all the steam will be kept inside.
And put it again in the clay oven.
Yes. For about how long?
Half an hour.
Okay, about 30 minutes.
Yeah. Okay, it's very hot.
Hot and heavy.
Yeah. Now we're going to put it again in the clay oven. Okay?
Yes.